is a man who has been in the ring with everyone from Mick Foley to the great Muta. But for Martin Stone, his career will never be complete unless he can say he was the first man ever to be the FWA World Heavyweight Champion. Yeah. Right now, it's all about Martin Stone, Johnny Midnight and Lionheart. As Lionheart is on the national stage, there's a lariat from Stone, almost took Midnight's head off.
Swing right there from Martin Stone.
But the thing with Stone, he's got so many moves in his arsenal. There's a new one he's been using recently. He goes for the cover. Stone, it sounds like he's trying to get Midnight in that London Bridge. A DDT, but Lionheart with a stiff kick to the side of the head of the governor. This is a real make or break moment in the match. Wait, Stone is there now. What's Stone doing? Stone, oh my God, my God! A powerbomb into a suplex by the governor, Martin Stone.
This man's just unstoppable, it's ridiculous.
The family driver from Stone. Goes for the cover. No, he doesn't go for the cover. That's a crossface. Crossface on Midnight. Midnight is tapping. Midnight is tapping. And Martin Stone is into the semi-finals. Tonight at Carpe Diem, he starts the night by becoming the first man into the final four. I don't know if anyone, Greg Lambert, can stop this man.
Look, I'm more concerned about this present moment in time, about Dave Ray. Now, he may have thought all his dreams had come true when he won a three-way at Revolution Begins last week to qualify for the World Title Tournament. Having seen who his opponent's going to be tonight, Dave Ray's dreams, they've turned to a nightmare.
God, look at Johnny Moss. He is just an absolute monster of a man. I mean, as much as I like Dave Rain, Greg, I hate to agree with you, but how on earth, if you're Dave Rain, can you possibly approach this match?
Never is Dave Rain going to have any chance in this match.
The way Moss is screaming at Rain. Dave Rain just doesn't seem to know what to do. As Moss,
oh, there you go,
overhead, belly to belly, and well, Rain landed hard on his head. Again, like Martin Stone in the previous match, there's so many ways he can beat you. As Moss again, a German suplex. Well, Rain's unconscious here, it looks like. Battle Royal on one side earlier, as Moss, another German suplex. And
how many times has he dropped Dave Rain on his head?
This is getting a little bit tough to watch. Moving, but he doesn't know where he is.
Dave Rain's insane. He's playing. Look at this. Dave Rain up. Oh, no!
And Moss is holding on. Oh, now, come on now. You could beat him at any time, Moss. For goodness sake, that's two German suplexes in a row. Moss still holding on with that waist lock. And a third German suplex. Oh, my. Rain's not holding up. He hasn't moved at all. There's 10, and Moss has won it. Dear God. Rain is at the very least concussed. Johnny Moss. Unbelievable. And you know what this means?
Yeah, I was just thinking. Who's Moss going to fight in the semi-finals?
It's going to be Moss and Martin Stone.
Oh.
Talk about a clash of two just unstoppable powerhouses. Stone and Moss. Leroy Kincaid is appearing in the FWA, the new FWA, for the second time. He was here at New Frontiers in a qualifier for the World Heavyweight Championship Tournament, eliminated after a double countout with Pac.
I recognise that music, Bradshaw.
What, hang on, Leroy Kincaid is mid-sentence here.
I tell you what, you're about to get a musical education right here. Never mind hip-hop. Here comes the future legend, the baby Jesus of British wrestling. It's the rock star Spud. Show some respect for the rock star, and he's particularly fetching. Security guard, look at her.
You've got a real thing for her, haven't you?
She's telling her.
Why is Rockstar Spud here? He has no reason to be out here.
Just a minute, the shades are going on. But he's going to do another one later on tonight. We should feel privileged.
No Rockstar Spud is in the building!
What did he say? That's a car battery.
What a coincidence.
Right, I'm about to take this punk right back to school. How can you try to test me when you're only about 4 foot tall? Let's do it like this. I'm gonna fight you. On my knees. That's all it's fair to you.
They're about the same height now.
Let's go.
I don't even know what that means. There we go.
Everyone, I'm gonna go on to the main event and qualify in the next round of the FWA Heavyweight Championship Tournament. Why? Because what a rock star was. A rock star, yeah! Stay on your team!
Well, maybe you can now see the car battery that Rockstar Spud carried to the ring, which has obviously been removed from Johnny Storm's car. Most red-hot tag team in Great Britain. Wisecracks, wasn't it? Oh, hang on, leaders! Leaders have been jumped from behind by Northern Exposure!
A mistake from a rookie team we've never seen before, as you allude to, play to NXT champs.
Double dropkick from, look like they're gonna try and fly here! Oh, well, referee Tommy Stevens has stopped them from doing so. Why on earth? Wait, hang on! Zack Sabre Jr.'s going for that cross arm breaker! No, no, no. So we do some damage though, and that's what Zack Sabre Jr. and Marty Scuddle have done. Oh, I think Tommy Stevens has given a yellow card to Zack Sabre Jr. For a 20-month winning streak, a kick to the face from Asa, see you later!
Asa, no!
This is how they beat them last month! Sabre, go for the pin, Zack! He does! I think Tommy Stevens is saying Sabre Jr. is not the legal man.
That's where being a rule stickler and a moaning windbag can pay dividends. Oh, there's a teenage kick, Dave!
Oh, my! He's taken his head off! He's taken Zack Sabre Jr.'s head off!
Oh, get in there.
Ace picks up the win.
Stop crying your heart out, Dave Bradshaw. What a victory for Northern Exposure. No, you can't do that! Oh, that's disgraceful!
Bubblegum got early near fall on Joel Redman. Fighting Redman with everything he had. This is reminiscent of how he started the match against Dave Morales at New Frontiers, and we all know how that ended. Then with a bear hug and Meyer overhead belly to belly, and Bubblegum landed awkwardly in those turnbuckles. Redman charging at Bubblegum. Look at that boot up, did Bubblegum. Trying to mount a comeback here at all. It is true, Redman growing up in such an isolated environment.
So again, though, I say Bubblegum showing, excuse me, he's showing impressive stickability. He's staying with Joel Redman.
If Bubblegum hadn't have beat Redman, is going for a superplex. If he nails this, Bubblegum's dreams have to be over. Oh, and Bubblegum swings around.
No,
I can hear what you were saying. Goodness.
And what's this?
Now what? That's the cartel's music.
No, they're not here. They can't be here. They're suspended.
Oh, look up high. There's no. Bubblegum. Crossbody from Bubblegum. Referee's up tonight and Bubblegum's in! Bubblegum is in!
No way!
Don't tell me! Bubblegum has beaten Joe Redman! Dear God, what a moment here in the Broxbourne Civic Hall at Carpe Diem!